In 1959, the Queen and Prince Philip came to Guelph, Ontario, and we joined the excited crowds on the main street. I remember being a little disappointed that the Queen wasn't wearing her crown, but it was all very thrilling nonetheless. Afterwards, I spied a train parked on the tracks near the station, and someone said that that was the Queen's train. I ran ahead and stood below the caboose, and just then the Queen came out. And she looked down and she smiled at me. A photograph I found just recently, which is not of me, but it's very similar, uncannily recalls that experience. My two older brothers scoffed at this and said, "You're making things up again, Huey." But I've never forgotten it.
That 1959 visit remains the longest royal tour in Canadian history. The Queen and Prince Philip visited all 10 provinces and 2 territories, covering 15,000 miles in 45 days, making 400 appearances and shaking well over 7,000 hands. She inaugurated the St. Lawrence Seaway with President Eisenhower and also visited Washington and Chicago, where she made it clear in her speeches that she was there as Queen of Canada. At a dinner she hosted for President Eisenhower was held at the Canadian Embassy in Washington and not the British Embassy.
While in Toronto, the Queen took special pleasure in attending the 100th running of the Queen's Plate on June 30th, 1959. She joined tycoon E.P. Taylor in his box to see his horse, New Providence, win the race.
"It is 100 years of nationhood that we celebrate today," said the Queen as she cut the centennial birthday cake in Ottawa on Canada Day, 1967. 2 days later, she was in Montreal visiting the crown jewel of the centennial celebrations, Expo 67, Man and His World. After touring the British Pavilion that morning, the Queen told Prime Minister Lester Pearson over lunch that she would like to ride the mini rail. This threw the security people into a tizzy, since there was no way they could clear the area in time. But she is, after all, the Queen, and so following lunch, Her Majesty rode the mini rail for 40 minutes to the delight of the spectators and herself. Later, she visited the Ontario Pavilion and viewed one of the most popular films at Expo, Christopher Chapman's A Place to Stand, where she kicked off her shoes and beamed at the movie's catchy theme song.
To Stand won the Oscar for Best Live-Action Short Film in 1967, and its theme song would become the unofficial anthem of Ontario for many years afterward.